laugh when you smile at me. All the clouds roll away. Liza, Liza, don't delay. Come keep me company, and the clouds will roll away.
Judy, Mama. Or Mama Judy. Jiminy Christmas, that's terrific. Lending the kid your mink coat and everything.
Oh, well, it isn't anything any mother wouldn't do. Besides, it's Liza's coat. I just...
Oh, I understand. Believe me, Judy. I mean, boy, what mother wouldn't be nervous under these circumstances?
Circumstances? What?
Yeah, boy, I'd sure hate to be in your shoes.
I wouldn't like to see you in my shoes.
Oh, you know what I mean.
No, I don't.
Oh, you got your own performance to think about. And then on top of that, you've got Liza to worry about.
What's the worry about Liza? What's the matter with Liza?
Oh, come on, Judy. Now, you're a great little actress, but you can't kid me. Your little baby working with you for the first time in front of millions of strangers.
Yeah. That's kind of terrifying when you come to think of it, huh?
Yeah.
I mean, it's...
Oh, Judy, now, come on. Yeah, you don't have a thing to worry about.
I know. It's just a, it's not I like singing
talent.
Around the house.
I know talent when I see him. Believe me, Liza's just going to be great.
I know she's going to be great. I'm worried about myself.
Oh.
It's the first time we've really worked together on a great big television show. And it's not just like singing around the house. I'm
yeah.
rather worried.
Yeah. Aren't you glad you got me around to cheer you up, though, huh?
Yeah. You're a real tower.
That's what I'm here for.
Hi, Jerry.
Hi, Liza. How are you?
Fine. Where's Mama?
You mean Judy?
Yeah, Mama.
Imagine calling Judy Garland Mama.
Imagine calling Mama Judy Garland.
Yeah. I guess it's kind of the same with me and Dick.
Oh, Dick Van Dyke is your father?
Oh. Yeah.
Come shine high as a mountain, deep as a river. Come rain, or come shine. I guess when you met me, it was just one of those things. But don't ever bet me. I'm with you. you will model through whatever we do together. Show? You want to be on it? You like?
Yeah, yeah.
What do you think of us?
I don't know. What do you think?
I think we're all right. I think we're pretty good.
I do too, Mom.
We're fine. You look marvelous.
Thank you.
You are
so
feeling good? No, I'm going to leave it on.
Wait, Mom, where
What's
are you
the
going?
What?
Well, you said through thick and through thin, all out or all in, remember?
Yeah. That's all right. I'm out and you're in now. Go, Liza. We're fine. Go on, yeah, go on,
Mom.
Liza. Go, Liza. Go, go, go!
Goes nothing.
Don't listen to the weatherman if he should mention there's a storm brewing. Don't let him ruin your day. I got a feeling that everything is gonna be okay. Gray skies are gonna clear up, put on a happy face. Brush off the clouds and cheer up, put on a happy face.
Ah! to do happy face. Put a little smile on your face.
Okay, you can come out. Hi, Liza.
Hi.
How are you? Boy, I tell you, that number of yours is just nifty.
Oh,
great.
Thank you. Hey, what do you got in your case?
What case? Oh, this. Oh, that's this is my banjo.
Okay.
Okay, Soup, you can come out now.
Oh, those strings smart.
Hope you didn't hurt my banjo.
Hurt your banjo? How about my nose?
Yeah, how about your nose?
Well, where is she? Where is she?
She's in the dressing room.
Shh. What do you mean, shh? 3 weeks you've been on the show with my idol, Judy Garland, Miss Showbiz. Oh, Swanee, how I love you, how I love you. My girl, Swanee.
Hey, that's great. I didn't know you did Jerry Lewis impressions.
Oh, come on now, come on. That's what shows you what you know about Judy Garland. Doggone it, she does that song better than Jolson. She does any song better than anybody. Where's Miss Judy?
Hold it down,
hold it down? Come on, you didn't set it up for me to meet Judy Garland after all, did you? And you promised.
Well, not exactly,
oh,
Soup.
Oh, fine friend.
Well, I meant too honest, but she's been so darn busy, you know. I'll tell
just
you.
Just go ape.
If you'll just calm down, I'll go get her. Just calm down.
Right now, right here on the stage, I get to meet Judy Garland, she and me, right here on the stage. Oh, I can't stand it.
Soupy, hold it down.
Hold it down.
Be calm.
I'm calm. Oh. I don't care about it there. Yeah. Come on. Are you kidding? I'm calm, I'm perfectly calm, I'm utterly under control. I haven't a worry where others would hurry, I stroll. I'm calm, I'm cool, a gibbering fool is one thing I'll never become. When thunder is rumbling and others are crumbling, I hum.
You must think calm, comforting things. Butterfly wings, emerald rays, or a murmuring brook, murmuring.
Look,
you're calm, you're perfectly calm. I'm utterly under control.
Oh, control.
Let nothing confuse me, or face me.
Excuse me.
I'm calm.
Oh, so calm.
Yeah? Oh, so calm.
Hey, that's great. Hey, Judy?
Oh, he's going to get her. I don't know. I'm just excited. I don't know what. I'm calm,
I'm perfectly calm, indifferent to tensions and shocks. Unruffled and ready, my nerves are as steady as rocks. I'm calm, controlled, so cool that I'm cold, aloofer than any giraffe. Oh, when something's the matter where others would shatter, I laugh. You must breathe deep, ever so deep. Think about she going to sleep. Stop and count up to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. When you need a plum and want to be calm, 'cause life is a horrible dream, just count up to 10 very slowly and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Hi, fellas.
Yeah. Ah!
We could make such beautiful music together. We could sing the loveliest music together. For we could make such beautiful music started to hum. Still, it's a real good bet, the best is yet to come. Working on my show.
I've never worked so hard in my life, but I like it a lot.
I know, darling. You're my favorite guest star. You really are.
You're my favorite mother.
I think you better sit down. You're out of breath.
Well, why don't you sit down?
You know, I feel real dumb when you do that. good. It's very hard to bawl you out when you're taller than I say. Now, you should get home on time. You should eat your cereal, Liza, and you're pointing upward. Doesn't make any sense. Lie down.
I'm sorry, Mom, but you see, I do eat my cereal. That's why I got bigger than you.
Uh-huh. You're smart, too, huh? I think they'll begin to stare at us.
Yes.
In a minute. You think we ought to sing?
Yes.
I think so. What do we do? Bob White?
Yes.
Huh? All right, but how long have you been doing this?
12 years.
On this show?
No.
Well, let's try it again. Come on, we ought to know it by now, shall we? Okay. I was talking to the mockingbird. He says you were the worst he's heard. Bob White, what you gonna swing tonight? I was talking to the whippoorwill. He says you got a corny trill. Bob White, what you gonna swing tonight? Even the album threw in a towel after you sang the gatto. And the flamingo hollered right jingo. What a vibrato! There's a lot of talk about you, Bob. And they're saying you're off the car. Take it, Mr. B, take it. Follow me, Bob White. For a bop a bop. We're gonna bring it up tonight,
Dressing room one, that's her room. I'll get it, sweet little old wardrobe, ma'am. Oh, at last we're gonna meet. At last. Can't forget you, Lily Mars.
I'm
coming. Oh.
Hi, who are you?
Judy Garland.
That's funny. That's my name, too.
All my life, I've dreamed of this moment.
Yeah?
Oh.
Say, I recognize you. Oh. Aren't you Soupy Sales?
Yeah, yes,
well, you know my children.
Oh, thank you.
And my children listen to you. Reckon they see also all those pies you threw.
Well, don't discourage them. Right. Listen, you're my hobby. I'm your favorite fan.
Really?
I've seen every picture you ever made.
Really?
Can I help you?
Yes,
I'll get just a second here. I
watch it though.
Yes. Oh, yeah. I just went. You're just wonderful. And I just love. I have all your records. And I've seen everything you ever done. And I'm in all the.
How long do you think this is going to take?
Not too long. So don't
inhale. Fine. I won't pick up over the fifth row. Fine. Thank you very much. Ow!
Oh, 1,000 pardons.
That's all right.
She is wounded.
Oh, the pain.
I can't stand.
No, it's all right. It didn't hurt me very much.
Not your hand, my head.
Oh,
that's what it is.
You shouldn't be so emotional. You ready to pull yourself together.
Listen. Miss Garland.
Yes.
If I sort of hung around the show, would it bug you?
Would I what?
If I hung around the show, would it bug you? Bug? Would bother you?
No, you're fine.
She's really Miss Showbiz.
Oh, hi here. There. Good evening, Germans and ladles and folks. I've been asked to make an announcement. Well, not really. Actually, I've been told to make an announcement. Announcement. In the interest of good neighborliness and the good entertainment, the Judy Garland Show, I bet you thought I was going to say Goody Jarland Show. Well, I'm not. Here directly from Mexico City are four young musicians who call themselves the Brothers Castro. They sing, they play musical instruments, and they don't have a banjo player. Hi, gang.
How are you?
I've
always said that.
It's all right if I sit in with you guys, you know, banjo, play with you. There you are. Well, what'd you decide, huh?
No, comprendo.
Okay, here we go. Ready? Here we go. Malaguena. Here we go. One, two, three. Here we go. Okay. Malaguena. Oh, here we go. One, two, three. Malaguena. Ole. Here we go. One, two, three. One,
necesito en mi vivir, pues cuando estás cerca de mí me siento muy feliz. Tú y yo seremos lo mismo que ayer, un par de enamorados que nunca jamás se podrán separar. Tururú. Quiero que sepas bien que me hace sentirme joven y que tu gran amor es tan maravilloso y genial. Sonreír cuando está triste mi corazón, pues tú me haces muy feliz. You make me feel so young. Wa-pa-da-da, wa-wa.
magnificent.
Is that commercial?
No, your song. It was fantastic. No, that's not it. What's the word I'm searching for?
Adequate?
Oh, come on. A soft-boiled egg is adequate. You're a Bendel bonnet, a Shakespeare sonnet. You're Mickey Mouse.
No, I'm Liza Minnelli.
You're another baby Leroy, I'll tell you.
Come on, Jerry, I'm not a baby. I can remember all those old-time greats, too. I can remember Kukla, Fran, and Ollie.
Oh.
And Mr. Peepers.
Oh, Peepers.
And Winky Dink.
Oh, yeah, he's great. But that was on television, Liza. When I was growing up, the thing was, it was radio. Vic and Sade, Fred Allen, the Lone Ranger.
Yeah, well, I've seen him on television.
Oh, yeah, but that was not the real Lone Ranger. That was just some play actor taken off on the part. But boy, when I was a boy, I used to listen to him every day on the radio. Every day he came on. I remember the first program he ever did, as a matter of fact, it was called The Lone Ranger Becomes the Lone Ranger. It's where he met Tonto, and I'll tell you, it was just great. It started with the William Tell Overture, and you could just hear the Lone Ranger riding out way off in the distance.
A cloud of dust and a hearty hi-yo, Silver, the Lone Ranger. This is the legend of a man who buried his identity to dedicate his life to the service of humanity and country. It is the story of the origin of the Lone Ranger. Early settlers in the West had to be brave men and women, ready to fight for their lives at any moment. There was danger on every side. There were wild beasts, savage Indians, and the Cavendish Gang. Butch Cavendish headed a pack of outlaws. They struck without warning to steal and kill.
Open fire on that wagon train. Wipe them out to their last mouth.
The Texas Rangers learned where Butch Cavendish and his gang were hiding.
Here come the Texas Rangers.
Six Texas Rangers guided their horses along a canyon floor to arrest the Cavendish gang. Presently, Captain Reed signaled a halt.
Right in, boys.
It was a good idea to send Collins, our guide, on ahead.
It was Captain Reed's younger brother who asked the question. The captain explained that Collins, who was not a Texas Ranger, was the only man who knew the country and who could scout ahead for information. Then, while the Texas Rangers waited for the guide's return, the captain said to his younger brother,
My wife and son are coming from the East. If something happens to me and you survive, well, I know you'll take care of her and Danny.
Right.
That silver will be staked out. See that my son and his mother get my share.
I promise.
Here comes.
Oh, what's the word, Collins?
Good news, Captain Reed. It's all clear. I scouted the rim on both sides of the canyon and found no sign of the Cavendish outfit.
All right, boys, let's go. Get up there.
Collins, the guide, lagged behind unnoticed by the Texas Rangers, who moved in single file along the floor of the canyon. They didn't know that Collins had lied, that Butch Cavendish and his killers were waiting in ambush on the rim on both sides of the gap.
Here come those Rangers, boys, just as Collins told us.
Yeah.
I've gone a long way back, and it'll be dark in half an hour. So we'll just keep pouring lead into them from up here until we're sure they're dead. Then we won't be taking any chances.
Now open fire!
The Rangers leap from their saddles and spread out as they return the fire on both sides of the canyon. Soon, four of the Rangers were killed. Captain Dan Reed and his brother, wounded several times, kept fighting side by side. Then the captain fell mortally wounded, and a moment later, his younger brother, the last of the Rangers, slumped to the ground.
It's pretty good acting, ain't it?
The outlaws waited and watched for any sign of life from the Rangers, then rode away, convinced that all six men in Bryant's Gap were dead. Sunset came. Then darkness.
Here come Tonto.
Ida and the Indian examined the bodies by moonlight. After examining the first five men, he muttered softly, Then he came to the sixth man, the younger brother of the captain.
And this man, lying, when you wake, land.
Yes, I... But so weak.
You wounded man.
I remember an ambush.
But you're so familiar about you. You remember? Many year ago, you only boy, you find Indian boy in trouble. You saved life, Indian boy.
Yes. Your name is Tonto.
That right?
Call me Kimosabe.
That right. And you still Kimosabe. It means...
There were six of us in that canyon. The others. What about the other rangers?
Other ranger? All dead.
Dead. It's my brother.
You, only ranger left.
Look out, here it comes.
You, lone ranger.
Those killers know me by sight. If they know one man escaped, they look for him.
And them not know one escape. Tonto bury five men, make six grave. Crook think you die with others.
Good. Then my name shall be forever buried with my brother and my friends. From now on, my face must be concealed. A disguise, perhaps, or a mask. That's it, a mask. I'm the only one who knows about the Cavendish gang. With your help, Tonto, I'll get every one of those crooks.
In the ranger's eyes, there was a light that must have burned in the eyes of knights in armor. The light that through the ages lifted the souls of strong men who fought for justice.
I'll be the Lone Ranger.
I feel.
spirits to climb. So let me entertain you, and we'll have a real good time.
I won't come back when the sun refuses to shine and
Liza Minnelli is a cousin of mine.
There's nobody like my mother. I'm going to show you the wrong to have become a promenade. I want to tell you, I won't tell me a lot of
things.
I'm not sincerely, but why I'm so blue, then maybe
I will come back to you.
You